To create a character Lora, you need about 20 to 30 images, preferably all at 512 by 512 pixels to reduce the training time. The most important part though is the image quality, captioning and variety. Notice how these images all have different shot sizes, surroundings and lighting. Also, she's wearing different clothes. Each image has a text file with the same name that describes the image. The description is basically the prompt you would enter to try and generate that image. The order isn't too important, but I usually start by describing the shot size, angle and style, and then add the name of the subject. This is where sometimes you would use a trigger word to make sure the model doesn't confuse it with something else it already knows. For example, I wouldn't call her Marilyn because image generators like Flux and Wan probably have been trained on a bunch of Marilyn Monroe pictures already and would most likely add Marilyn Monroe features to your model once you generate an image. So if there's any chance it's a famous word or name, you should probably add some numbers in there or call it something entirely else. After that, you describe what she's doing and what she's wearing. Then make sure to describe the background. If you have a bunch of pictures of someone at the beach and you don't tell the trainer there's a beach in the background, then it will assume that beach belongs to the Lora, and later images will often show a beach even though you didn't ask for it. Same goes for clothes, for example. Basically, you are describing all the things that you want to be able to change later. You're not describing her facial features because they should always be the same. In the end, add the lighting. Now repeat this for all the images in your dataset. There are automatic captioning tools that can help you, but personally, I prefer doing it manually. You can use video clips too, but you only really need them if you want to train a certain motion or action. If you do need videos, I recommend you prepare them to be 512 by 512 pixels, 16 frames per second, and just slightly over 3 seconds long each. Keep in mind though, having videos increases the training time quite a bit.